Hey Ross World, my money makes money. Tulsa Real Estate Fund. Tulsa Real Estate Fund. For short, I'm just gonna call it TRIF throughout the video. Now, this is another form of crowdfunding for properties in the urban development area all around the world, whether it be in the United States or other urban development places around the world. And this is another minimum deposit of $500 for you to invest your money. Now, this is kind of different in a sense that it is backed by the SEC. That's the U.S. Security and Exchange Commission. And they're registered with them. And it's a government program that you can invest starting off $500 and you will receive 8% of the return and equity and also 50% of the amount of money that you invested off that particular property. And they're investing in houses, hospitals, community centers, stores, and particular communities. Now, for my non-minority white listeners, please don't be offended. Please don't be offended. Now, this program seems to be targeted at the black and brown community for us to start using our spending power, which is about $1.2 trillion to be invested back into our own neighborhoods. Because if anybody out there from the DMV area, that's the DC, Maryland, Virginia area, and it's probably happening in other places around the country, is that gentrification has hurt a lot of the urban black and brown areas. And what that means quite simply is they allow violence, corruption, drugs to increase and multiply in order for property value to go down, for them in order to come in, a more affluent people of a certain, it could be Jews, it could be whites, it can be whoever. But once again, this is not a target video about race, but the fund actually is targeting race. So please understand what I'm getting at here. They come in, they buy up all the low rundown property, they break it all down, they rebuild it back up. And now where the rent was maybe $700-$800, the basic rent is now $1,500. Now those people that lived in that neighborhood can no longer afford, they can no longer live there. So they have to move to another area that's probably ran down, infested with drugs. And guess what, guys? And some of you are saying, well, they did it to their own neighborhood. Some of them did. But not all of them, okay? Not all of them. Some of them are just victim of their society, victim of their neighborhood, victim of their community, and I'm not giving anyone a pass, okay? Because I grew up in the ghetto and I made a choice, okay? And you're saying, well, some people don't have a choice. Now, that's controversial, but I believe everybody has a choice, either to be a part of the system that's bringing down your neighborhood, or doing something else, doing something positive. I'm off of it. Tulsa Real Estate Fund is meant for anyone to invest their money into urban developments around the world. But I just want to bring this out. We're talking about 8% equity return and 50% of the commercial property return that you'll be receiving back in your money. The good thing about this is it's backed by the SEC. And if anyone knows anything about the SEC, even though it's part of the federal government, it's independently ran, okay? Independently ran. But understand that this is a real estate opportunity, is when they start building these properties back, building these communities back, that you will start making profit. Now, I've done a little research on this, but I had to turn the tide. I had to turn the tide because, once again, Ross World, I have to give you the butt-naked truth. Where I'm from, I've seen ghettos, low impoverished neighborhoods, redone and redone and redone again. What does that mean? That means whoever came in there and they redid the neighborhood, they redid that community, they kept the prices to a point where people could afford it. But if a neighborhood is redone three times, what is that telling you? That means that drug, crime, infestation, criminals, and all types of would-be characters is running down that property. And so when people are not paying their rent, no one with any sense wants to live there. And so that neighborhood actually brings in the attention of drug addicts and drug dealers and killers and robbers and stealing. So you're saying, so why are you telling us about Tripp if you know that this may be one of those things? I don't know. This is kind of different. A lot of those properties are independent investors that they come in and try to make profit off non-white people. But this is kind of different because it's backed by the SEC. So I think there's a real plan in place. But at the same time, I got to give you the real. Once again, back in D.C., there's a neighborhood where my aunt used to live. And they came in and they rebuilt. These were ghettos. These were ghettos. I mean, bars on the windows on the bottom floor. This was a real ghetto, okay? I should know. I stayed with my aunt a couple of days and some things popped off and we had a duck a couple of nights. So that got teared down and rebuilt by condos. Now, that property, I don't know the worth, but I know to even get into that neighborhood, you have to pay at least $1,200. So I'm really trying to figure out Tripp. Now, this video came from LaShawn Major. He's the one who brought this to my attention. Thank you, LaShawn. But, of course, I have to put my spin on it because I have to give the people the real deal. And this has to really to do what I think and how I feel about it. So, the main question you'll probably ask is, Ross World, are you going to invest in it? I'm not going to invest in it right now. I have to get some more analytical, statistical data, or data, however you say it, in order to invest inside this property. Because right now, as far as my knowledge, I think it just took off in 2016. I may be wrong on the year, excuse me. But to me, it's not enough data or reviews or information out there for me to just to throw $500 inside of an investment or even to allocate money per month to put inside this investment. It's just not enough information on it. And because of the volatility of it, you know, this is very vital and critical because I grew up in the ghetto. So I have firsthand knowledge of how some people treat their property and how the property value goes down and how the property value goes up. This has a lot to do with how we were raised. And you know what I'm talking about. For those who grew up in the ghetto, in the slums, in poverty, in the trailer parks, you know what I'm talking about, the mindset of these people. And On a whole, a lot of us are great people. We just had bad influences. But when we all get together in that neighborhood, somehow something goes haywire and that neighborhood becomes unsafe. And I'm not putting down Tripp. This is a great push. This is a great program. And I want it to succeed. I want to invest inside of it for it to succeed. But I'm never going to advise anyone to invest. This is simply your choice. I'm giving the information, and you know, well, you say you want to go invest, and I understand, and I'm really persuasive in the way I'm talking about it, so you may lean not to, but no, don't take my word for it. Do your own research. Me, I just need a little bit more. This is me, guys. You may not need a little bit more. You probably say, you know what, if I lose $500, that's fine. It's a good cause. I want to invest in a good cause. I'm not knocking it. By all means, invest. Use our 1.2 trillion spending power to use. I'm just saying for me, you know, I'm always real with you guys because I don't want to be a fake ass dude. I'm not going to do it right now because I'm not quite too sure how it's going to take off. But I'm going to monitor it. I'm going to watch it. Once again, I thank LaShawn Major for bringing this out there so the people get the information. But statistics and analytics will be the cause for me to invest or not to invest. And one more thing, when you're a trendsetter, when you're a starter, when you're one of the first people to join something, it's a risk, okay? And if you have two sides. You have a good risk and you have a bad risk. The good risk, these people turn out to be millionaires very quickly. A bad risk, you end up in a poorhouse. But nevertheless, we all know that investing inside of anything, in anything, is a risk. But you decide how much you want to invest. Once again, this is a good cause. And once again, this is backed by the SEC and they are registered. So do your own research. Don't take my personal opinion for your decision. It's all about what you think. But for me and mine, we're going to wait this a little bit longer because we spend our money on everything. And let me break this down really quickly. I'm not trying to be too long. We make money from corporations. We then take that money and give it back to corporations, and we don't invest it. The only way, in order for you to make money substantially, is to take the money that you get for working for that corporation and investing it in corporations, and they're going to pay you back money. Because as the middle class and lower class, we are the ones who make the high class and the rich rich, because we are simply consuming and not investing. They are willing to take the risk of investing, and it is a risk, but they are being profitable every day, making money off of us, because every time you go buy whatever it is, from food to clothes to electronics, you're making somebody rich, because you are a consumer and you're not an investor, inventor, or innovator. So you have to choose one. I'm talking about investing. If you're an inventor, then invent. If you're an innovator, then innovate. But if you're not an innovator or inventor, then you must invest. This is the only way. So, Trip, Tulsa Real Estate Fund, go give it a look. I'll have the link in the description. This is Ross World. We're trying to find multiple diverse ways in order to make us more money. I'm out.